kids, him and his wife. So that's 8. And then R5, that's 13. So you're talking about 13 people in one bedroom house, and there was one bathroom, which is making everything work. But during the summertime, it's like we went out and like camped in my brother's yard. He had a big yard. George's been there three times.
Yeah.
He had a big yard. We, Chrissy and I, during the summertime, because there were so many people living there, we brought out our tent and camped out in the back. During the cold season, I don't know if you guys remember, we had the Yukon, the GMC Yukon we used to have.
Yeah.
During the cold season, if we got tired of, you know, being crowded inside the house, that her and I, we fixed our bed in the back of our Yukon. And then all the kids were inside in the living room. So we're
happy outside, Christine.
yeah. And again, because it's family, and because you work together and you support, you know, one another as family.
Yeah.
I've told George, like, you know, history of me when I lived in California, I was homeless for 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, when I had to move out of my apartment, a lot of times it's like I'm not really worried about it because I already know I've been to a point where, you know, where I've lived under without it. But then I have to think about, like, my kids and my family. Sometimes, like, her and Liza would be in Isaiah. What was that one car we had? It was like an 80-something Toyota Corolla wagon. And we had her and my kids. They were like, I put the back seat down and the three were like laid out in the back.
In California?
No, here in Washington.
Oh, in here?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Like, to me, like, anything, no matter if it's a car or whatever, to me, it's still a roof.
Yeah.